here we are out in the property. Just did a little routine walk around. Deer season's been gone now for about a month full now. I like to do my intel for next season's stand placements and stuff at the very end of the season, because this is the time when you're gonna see all of that October, November, December, January patterns of trails that were used the most, looking for a lot of hair on fence crossings, stuff like that. That's what I'm looking for this time of year to strategize for next year, especially on a property like this, where this is the first season we ever had hunting here. And so we had to learn a lot, but I'm gonna take some of the intel. I just went back on my phone. I use an app called Huntwise, pinned a bunch of different spots, different sign, different things and reasons for putting certain stands and bedding areas in certain locations and access points. And I just documented it all on my app and on my phone. And then I'm gonna start to apply those things here very soon, so that way it's done and ready for next season. So for those of you that care at all to know about that, that's what I was just doing. I'm on my way up to the barn though. We're gonna go run and actually pick up my father-in-law's Dodge 1500 that you guys saw in a few videos back where the transmission actually failed on it. Now, before too many of you Dodge transmission haters jump into the comments with joy to rip on the Dodge for having a bad transmission and going out on the truck, it was 262,000 miles on the original engine and transmission. I don't know about you, but for a truck that was produced in the mid 90s, with the transmission being literally bone stock other than, you know, periodic maintenance and stuff with fluids and flushing, that's pretty good. I mean, that's still pretty good. Then we're gonna go over the truck, a little bit of driving on our way into town and back, go over some of the stuff with you guys, and hopefully you guys like it. And here's a little update on our firewood journey here. We got a whole rick split there. And then we got another row starting. And then we got three freaking huge rows of 100% cherry, other than like two or three small pieces of oak that got mixed in, but almost 100% cherry right there. That's a lot of wood. It's a lot of firewood in the past handful of days as well. So pretty stoked about that. Gonna do a little bit more before the weather gets too awfully warm. It's in the 60s already today. Once it gets too hot, I'm done cutting wood. But while the weather's still like in the 40s, give or take, a little 50s here and there, beautiful time to get out there, cut a bunch of firewood, get it ready for next year. And if I have any surplus, maybe I'll throw it for sale. But it's pretty fun stuff. We're gonna get a little bit more done before the weather gets too warm. And then on to my deer habitat management objectives next. And do not forget, you can enter to win this beautiful first gen that comes with $5,000 in cash. It's 1990, zero rust, super clean truck. LNPgear.com, simply place an order and you're entered to win. And no promises here, but I might even have a giveaway winner to announce to you guys in this video for the third gen. I know that the comments have been raving on social media about the old third gen in that right tie.
People been loving it.
People been loving the idea of finding out who the winner is for that truck. Guys, 7 to 14 days is a generalization of roughly how long it takes to get a winner. Sometimes it takes 15 days, sometimes it takes 16 days, but moral of the story is 7 to 14 days is a generalization. I think it's been like 16 days since the third gen giveaway ended. The attorney did message me who does the drawing, and he said, I do have a winner. I will contact them today, and as soon as they get back to me, I will give you their contact information once they have been verified, so you are able to reach out to them. So hopefully that happens today. That way everybody can find out who it is and either have peace of mind or be absolutely devastated. I don't know. I guess it depends on the person, but we'll find out.
Looking for change, looking for pain, pulling a mob, pushing a train. I'll never stop, stick to a lane, pick up the pieces and go rearrange. I'll be the best above all the rest, put me to the test and expect nothing less. You check as I'm chess, what's happening next? Yeah. He got the venom, a tangible weapon, no coming in second. This life is a lesson. He got a new engine from pain, that's a blessing. New focus, no guessing, just bold and obsession. All in his possession, you got the retention. I'll leave an impression and take a redemption. Just kill no discretion, your mind is a weapon. 11-11, it's time for progression.
You could try to play, but you're never gonna beat me. Look the other way, what I'm doing ain't easy. Bloody and stained from
the first startup with the new transmission. Then we're gonna get this thing down the road here. mean, so far it feels good. Shifts are real firm, but they're not like, you know, they're not throw you out of the seat firm, but they grab and go nice. Thing idle's freaking low, man. I'm telling you, I don't know if that's normal or not. I think this is my first video of actually doing a drive around in this truck. As far as I remember, I don't know that I've ever done a ride-along video in this truck. It's a good one to do, too. New built transmission. And they did say that this thing was beefed up to handle over 400 horsepower. They said that it's got a 2-year warranty on it, 24,000 mile. And they made it sound like this transmission should give zero issues unless you just go absolutely insane with the power. Then of course it's outside of their issue if you break it, but they're like, if you stay within that 450 range, this thing should be able to take all the abuse. And it grabs and goes, so it's so touchy to the throttle now. Man, it's making me want to get my transmission built on my 1500 and get the exhaust work done that he's got. I don't know exactly what all he's got done with his exhaust, but it sounds so much better than mine. I like the sound of mine, but this just has like such a deep growl to it. Like it's, I don't know. It's definitely different though. It sounds really good. We're not going to do anything too harsh with it since, you know, it's not my truck, but not that I do anything too harsh with any of my trucks as it is, but with a new transmission, it's always fun to do a few good pulls with it so you can kind of get a good perspective on what RPMs the transmission's holding at, shifting at, how it holds, you know, RPM, acceleration, all that stuff. Kind of nice to feel how it holds you in the seat, I guess, when you put it down a little. I'm not going to do a 0 mph acceleration up to whatever, but I am going to let these vehicles in front of us get a little bit of distance once we get up onto this higher speed stretch of the interstate here and do a little bit of a pull. And again, this truck's got almost 264,000 miles on it. It's crazy. You know I gotta start the pull under this bridge and go. Like that. It's got that Dodge steering, you know. You can keep it going straight and you got just enough play in there, you know. Give it another little pull here starting at about 50. Very sensitive. Oh, that's nice. So when it shifts into overdrive like it is right now and it's maintaining like 1500 RPM at 60 miles per hour, which to me is just wild. Like that's good. If I hardly adjust my foot a little bit more on the throttle, it instantly downshifts and pulls and gives you that extra power you need. And the reason that's nice is because I know, at least from my experience, whether it's the second gen gas trucks or the diesels, usually for it to downshift, you have to like really lay into that throttle for it to like really take in a lot of extra fuel for it to actually downshift and grab and pull. Versus this is like, it's not so sensitive to where it's annoying. Like you could probably feather it and not have it downshift so hard. When you like put the pedal in it, just a little bit more than a feathering, it instantly starts to downshift and it holds that nice high RPM until you let off the throttle again, and then it lets down. which, you know, the principles behind that are like, well, that's what a good automatic transmission is supposed to do, which is why I'm saying that. I mean, it's on cue. It's perfect.
So now once we get around the corner here, I'm going to do another little pull starting from a whole lot slower than 40 and then 50 like I did with the last two. For this next one, I'm going to start a whole lot slower. I'm going to turn down this, of course. Oh no, she's not turning down this road. Good. So we're at 25, we're going to pull. Beautiful shifting. Beautiful. So smooth. Oh, that is beautiful. You don't have to feather the throttle at all. Oh man, I'm so used to in a 1500 or a diesel in these second gens, like if it's an automatic that's stock, you have to like pamper it between 45 and 50 to get it to shift into overdrive smooth, and you have to like feather it a little bit. This is just beautiful. Like when you put your foot in just a hair, because you're like almost just feeling like, ah, I'd like to pick up a little bit of speed. You just hardly touch that throttle in more than you are, and it'll downshift to pull your speed up to where you want it. And then as soon as you let out, it stops. Again, I know that's what you expect from a good automatic transmission, but anybody who knows these second gens with high miles on a stock transmission, they don't act like that. They usually need a little bit of babying to shift in and out of gears and get into overdrive smooth, you know. Beautiful. Man, that is hard to beat. For those of you that have not seen this truck yet, I know most of you probably have seen it from the previous content from a handful of videos back. But it is a gorgeous 97. And this truck has been in the same family since brand new. So I guess technically you can't call it a one owner, because my father-in-law was not the original buyer of it. His dad was, but I mean, this would definitely be considered one of those trucks that are really hard to get your hands on in terms of not being passed through a bunch of hands. It's pretty freaking nice. Even the guy at the shop was like, man, he's like, where did he get that truck? He's like, that thing is clean underneath the whole body. He's like, that thing is just nice. He's like, for that kind of mileage to be running that perfect. He's like, dude, he's like, who'd he buy that off of? I said, his dad, who worked at Mopar for 30 years. Next step is gonna be making a Costco run. And as much as I think you guys might enjoy that, I don't think I'm gonna be recording our Costco adventure for groceries. But do not forget, guys, that you can get entered to win this beautiful 1990 first-gen Dodge 12-valve Cummins. Thing is gorgeous. Beautiful interior, beautiful exterior. Thing is literally beautiful. If you guys wanna get entered to win this thing, plus $5,000, the giveaway for this truck does end on March 19th. That is not a whole lot of time left. That's hardly 3 weeks left to enter. And then the giveaway for this truck is going to be over. I have not heard back on the third gen winner update. So that, again, should be very, very soon. He did email me today stating that he has drawn a winner and he is going to be trying to get a hold of them today. But I have not heard yet any information on if they have picked up the phone and filled out any kind of documentation. And until they do that, I can't go putting a name out there just for liability reasons. I can't say any names until paperwork is all official and filled out. But anyways, guys, stay tuned, keep your phones close, and good luck.